Good morning, everybody. It is Monday, and I thought I'd vlog today. This is probably going to come out on a Wednesday, which would be the 15th of January. So I just finished making my iced coffee with a dash, or actually it's a scoop of the keto collagen powder. I think is what I found it on Aldi, and I got these today. I have been thinking about recoloring my Doc Martens, the red cherry ones, because I haven't really been using it, and I've had it for 10 years. I've had the pair of shoes for 10 years, but because of its color being red cherry, I find it difficult to pair it with a lot of the things that are in my wardrobe. Just because I don't have a lot of things that would go with that. I was initially thinking of painting it in black because I've always wanted a black pair of Doc Martens. And I do have black leather paint. So this is the one. This is all the leather paints that I have are by the Angelus brand. So this one is in black. And I used this before along with the Vachetta color. I used that before to recolor the faux Louis Vuitton that I got from the op shops. It was a Murakami collaboration with Louis Vuitton, the multicolored white one. And I wasn't a fan of the colors, and also because it was pretty obvious that it was fake. So I recolored that, and I believe I've posted a video on that. I'm just not sure if it's in this channel or in my Filipino channel. However, I digress. So I have the black and the Vachetta, and I realized that these sizes are way too big for what I need. Like, I painted an entire bag. It was the Alma bag. And I didn't even make a dent on that. So this time around, I just bought the smaller ones. So I've got English tan, navy blue, and white. Now, I'm fairly sure I'm not going to be using the white to paint the Doc Martens, nor am I going to be using the Vachetta, because I want it to be like a darker brown color. So I thought maybe English tan, but also I'm thinking about navy. So I can't really decide. Tell me what you think. But by the time this video is over, I would have already done it. Okay, so here are the Doc Martens that are in question. And as you can see, it hasn't been worn that much. But there are scuffings on the toes. I always get that in any of my shoes. I think it's just really the way I walk. But like, it's still in great condition, so actually I am having second thoughts about doing this, but I just want to give it a try. I don't know if I have to use the leather preparer and deglazer before I do anything with this. But yeah, I'm having second thoughts, but I know that I have to do it, because the reason why I haven't been wearing this is because of the color. So I just need to decide which color. I think I'm going to start with the English tan, and what I'll do is I will paint one side of, or one part of it, that color, and see if this is a color that I would actually want to permanently be on there. I don't know. Let's try navy. Okay, I think we're fine. I think we're gonna go with navy on this one, just because the English tan is a little bit too orange. And I'm thinking, look, if I get tired of navy, I could always paint it another color, or maybe even bring it to black. Yeah. So I'm gonna try and remove most of this if I can. Yeah, I'm probably going to do a deglazing first, because it seems that it's hard for the paint to actually go on the shoe because there's like a waxy sort of like film over it. So I'm going to deglaze this. I'm probably going to start with just doing the toe part up to here and maybe the heel and see if that's, if I want to keep it that way or if I want to paint the whole thing. Let's see. So because I haven't deglazed it, it only took like a wipe of wet cloth to remove those, but you can see that where there was scuffing, the paint actually went through, but this one it isn't going through because, and I did polish this many moons ago, so that's why it still got that waxy sort of like film over it. Anyways, let's get on with the deglazing. Okay, I'm kind of liking this color combination that I might just leave it like this. Like this top half and the tongue would be cherry red, whereas the rest of it will be navy blue. Kind of makes me think like something Captain Marvel would wear. Yeah. So anyway, that's just the first coat of the navy. I am going to wait for this to dry for at least 8 hours before putting on a second coat, or maybe 4 hours. It should be dry within 4 hours. I'll wait for it to dry for another 4 hours and then I'll put on the second coat. And I think in the second coat I'll be using a brush just so that it is more defined and I can go into the little corners and make sure that everything is painted as it should be. But I'm really digging this. Like, look. And then I'll put the yellow, oh my god, laces on here. So it's blue, red, and yellow. And then I'll wear white socks, which would then look like the Philippine flag. Oh my god, I love it. I love it. Okay, so that is the second coat done. And I used a brush so that I can get into the little nooks and crannies and make sure that everything is painted through. So I've got the front and the back both done. So the next thing that I need to do is to seal this, and I do have an acrylic finisher that I'm going to use after this has dried. So I'm going to wait another maybe 4 to 6 hours to make sure that it is completely dry before I go ahead and do the acrylic finisher. That way it will seal the whole paint. Okay, now for the final step, I'm going to seal it with the acrylic finisher, also from Angelus. This is not a sponsored video, by the way. It's just that I tend to buy from the same brand once I've already tested the quality. So it says here to use a paintbrush, sponge, or rag to apply evenly to leather and allow it to dry. Do not apply excessively or rub for a prolonged period of time. And yeah, so I'm just gonna go ahead and pour some of this. And from my experience with the bag that I changed colors off, I don't really need a lot, so I have to be careful because I don't really want to waste it. And I can always add some more if ever I don't have enough. So just this much is what I've poured so far. And I'm gonna go ahead and start with the first shoe. So really just like it said, don't rub too much, or for a prolonged period of time, don't use too much, so that one dip is enough for me to actually do this whole part of the shoe. That might have been actually a bit too much still, so just make sure that the whole shoe is covered with all of it. And don't worry that it's got like those little bubbles, because once that dries, it's gonna be okay. Okay, so I've put it all over, and you see the bubbles that was there earlier have now gone. So now the only thing that I need to do is to actually let it dry completely, and I will leave that like that overnight so that tomorrow I am assured that it is already completely dry. And I didn't have to add any more of that finisher. That was more than enough to cover everything. So hopefully that would stay put. And yeah, now I've got like a new pair of Doc Martens, and I love how it actually looks like it's new, right? It's like even the scuffing from before has disappeared. So yeah, I'm gonna put the laces on so you can see what it looks like with the yellow laces. Okay, so here we go with the finished pair of shoes. Navy and cherry red with yellow laces. I think that's dope. All right, well, thank you all again for joining me in this little DIY crafty kind of video. If you are interested in any more of these and want to see me do something else, then let me know. I have a pair of boots that I am thinking about DIYing, and it's patent leather or patent leather. We'll see how it goes. I have to research on what to do for that kind of material, and if leather paint would actually stick to it. So let's see.